So this is how a starter motor works. It's kind of taken apart, but this right here is the starter solenoid. It's kind of beat up, but all a solenoid is just a coil of wire. But if you run a current, an electrical current through a coil of wire, it creates a magnetic field in the middle of the coil, and the direction of that field is dependent on which way the current is flowing. So, you know, if you run a current through this, it can create a magnetic field this way or that way. Now, if you put something inside of here, a metal magnetic core, like a piece of iron or steel, what will happen is when you energize this, it will create the magnetic field, and that magnetic field will move the whatever is in the middle of here. And that's all this part is. It's just a solenoid. So this part connects onto the top of the starter. Now that you see there's a big spring here, and I'll explain that in a second. But what happens is this little plunger thing is what is inside that solenoid, or the coil of wire. So when it energizes, it will pull it back, and like when you turn the key and start the car, that energizes the solenoid. This pulls this back, and I'll explain what that does in a second. But when you let go of the key, this spring is what pushes this back. So this gets pulled back, compresses the spring, and then you let go of the key, and this pushes it back. Now, when this gets pulled back, I'm going to show you what happens when it gets pulled back. You see that? That is the gears. You see how it spins a little bit too? That's so it can engage the flywheel. These teeth right here engage the flywheel. Now, this whole thing, this whole bottom part is grounded to the battery. So, and then you have the positive cable that supplies power to this. So what happens is let's do this in slow motion. So it pulls it, the gear engages. Now when it touches the chassis right there, it will ground itself. And now all of a sudden the motor, the starter motor, has power. So it doesn't start the starter until these teeth are engaged and it grounds. So when that happens, it engages the motor in here. And you can see if I take off the back, there are these brushes, they call them brushes right here, that are on springs. And these are always pushed against the armature. The armature is the thing that spins in the middle. So many times when you have starter failure, all you need to do is open it up and replace these brushes, which are very cheap, you know, a couple of bucks, and that's it, your starter works. So let's open this even further. So you see this little arm here, see how it goes forward? That engages to this, and there you go, it goes in here. And then you can take this out of the housing. This is the armature, and you can see that these brushes are on springs to keep electrical contact with the armature. And this armature is what does all the receives all the big current and turns the motor. Now this is just an electrical motor. It kind of goes past the scope of this video to explain how an electrical motor works, but all it is a motor, but it's just really big and it takes a lot of current. And that's pretty much how a starter works in a nutshell. And you can see how on the outside it has coils of wire, and that's just like in an electric motor. So maybe I'll put a link of how reading about how an electric motor works, because that's all this is. And that's pretty much it. You can see it's not that bad. Like I said, a lot of the times these brushes are what go, and all you need to do is just open it up and replace these brushes. There's a little teeny nut right there to replace the brush. So either the brushes go or the solenoid goes, both you can repair, and that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching.